We've even got the chairman turned up.
Attention, please. Thank you very much, Paul, for coming on behalf of the Rickmansworth Museum. I say it's a very special day today that we've now got the opportunity to actually see inside the barn. So we're now going to take the opportunity to slowly walk up. It's about 8 to 10 minutes.
Well, I wanted to say hello to everyone and thank you so much for coming, and thank you for being so interested in the 1600 barn. It really is a wonderful place. But I wanted to talk to you first before you went into the barn. But first of all, I do want to welcome, particularly I want to welcome the leader of the council, Councillor Anshaw. I want to the chairman of the council, Councillor Chris Lloyd. Well, it all goes back to dear old Offa, King of Mercia, 700. And he lived down at the Manor of the Moor, you know, down by Moor Park Station. He lived there and he owned all this land. His favourite daughter was being married, or so the story goes, his favourite daughter was being married. He wanted the bridegroom because he could get all his land. Sadly, he went off the bridegroom on the wedding night and killed him. But poor old Arthur was so overcome with what he'd done that he got in touch with the Abbot of St Albans and said, if I give you all my land of Croxley, will you please pray for me that I get my place in heaven? Well, I think the old abbot thought, you know, a good thing. And so that's how it became under the Abbot of St Albans. And I like to think that those men, you know, 600 years ago, and when you go, this is what I wanted to see you all first, when you go in there and see the workmanship, like a cathedral, well, we put it here, it is like a cathedral inside. And those men, I mean, when you think they had to have so many skills, they had to know how to build brick walls, how to make that cement, they had to know how to do the, and they had to do the measuring and everything. They were absolutely brilliant. And then, of course, along comes Henry VIII. Henry VIII made the Church of England. All this land then became crown land. After that, it belonged to the county. But then they came away from the county and inherited the barn. And this is why it is as it is now. They can't afford, of course, to put it right. And so, hopefully, now we've got together like this, we may be able to help fund it, because now it ought to come under the museum. Thank you very much indeed.
Barbara, thank
you.
Who's
going to lead the way?
Thank you so much.
That oak tree there, that's a full oak tree.
I know you are, but
it's quite extraordinary. I mean, and all these other beams.